Hello everybody. Thank you so much for visiting Riders United YouTube channel, where I release weekly videos about the motorcycle upgrades, some tips and motorcycle related content. And today I have a really quick question for you. So let's say that I will give you $100. What will you spend your money on? I think that I have really good valuable tip that will help you to spend this money wisely and also save hundreds if not thousands of dollars on your motorcycle in the long run. So please stick around and I will show you what I got. Here we go. So over the years, I own multiple motorcycles in my life, and I have to say, this never ends. You always buy some upgrades, you always buy some parts and some of the cool accessories that you like for your bike. And I'm definitely no different. And I have to say, over the period of all these years, I spent probably thousands of dollars on some of those items that I purchased for my bike. But there was one item that I think that I spent this money in the best fashion ever, which allowed me to not only save money, but also save the time and get the valuable information. So you probably wonder what it is. And I have to say, it's definitely a service manual that I also have in here. So yes, this will run you about $100. So you probably wonder why I would recommend that you will spend your $100 on the service manual for your bike. And I can tell you really quickly the story that was part of my motorcycle experience. And about 15 years ago, I purchased a Harley-Davidson Sportster 1200 from one of the local towing companies. The bike was in terrible shape, but that was everything that I could afford at the time. I was a young kid in America. I have about $1,500 in my pocket. And this is exactly how much money I spent on the Sportster in order to get it, because the brand new one was about $10,000 and I definitely couldn't afford it at the time. So I bought this bike and my wife was laughing and she said, like, why are you buying this junk? This is just a terrible looking motorcycle. It have missing parts. But for me, it was just a dream coming true, because I was dreaming about owning a Harley for many, many years from the moment I was like 15-year-old kid. And suddenly I have the opportunity to buy the bike that was maybe not in the best shape, but at the same time, it was always a Harley. So I decided to give it a shot. And at the same time, I was wondering what I can do to fix this bike, because yes, I have some previous experience from one of the other bikes that I restored when I was about 17 years old, but that was definitely a different bike and it was something completely different for me to work on Harley-Davidson, which was my first Harley at the time. And after connecting with some of the Facebook groups, and actually that was a motorcycle forum up there, that I get the tip from somebody and they told me, maybe you should buy the service manual. And I was like, yeah, maybe I should give it a shot. So yes, I have to say it was difficult to spend $100 on the book, but I learned really quickly that that was the best money that I could spend on this bike at the same time. And you will probably ask, why will I do that? And I have to say, this specific information that is provided in the service manual, especially from the manufacturer of your bike, is really priceless. Many times we'll go to like the different forums or different groups on Facebook, and instead of getting your answer, people are making fun of you, or if they provide the answer, sometimes the answer might be not accurate, or they are missing like torque specs, or they don't provide any important tips that the service manual will provide for you. So as you can imagine, I mean, who is there better than the factory engineers to provide the tips for you when you are working on your motorcycle than the factory people? And I have to say, it was definitely something that make perfect sense to me. And what I really value about those service manual is the fact that sometimes it will allow me to decide if I want to approach specific job or not. So I can read the manual for the specific repair that I'm having in mind. And before I start doing anything, I can make sure that I have all the tools that I need. I have the skills that is that are required for doing the job. And also it will provide all this extra information that I might not know about when I'm thinking about this. And I actually encountered such a situation with my Sportster restoration. There was the valve guides that I have to replace on my bike. And of course the press was required for that. I didn't have the press at the time and I still don't have it actually. And I have to say, if I wouldn't know, I will probably take this heads off and, you know, I will probably try to do something crazy with it, or maybe like punch it out with the hammer, or doing something that, you know, I will try to get there without the appropriate equipment. But just by reading this service manual, it allowed me to decide, okay, maybe this job is a little bit too much for me. On the opposite side, there are also some of the maintenance items that you can definitely do on your bike that you think are really difficult. And one of those perfect examples will be replacing of the brake pads. I mean, yes, I did that before, but after I bought this bike, I was like, okay, you know, maybe I should just go to the dealer and pay somebody $100 to do it. But after just reading two or three pages of this service manual, I definitely felt confident that this is the job that I can do. And if you own the bike for a long period of time, and even if you are not mechanically inclined to do those big jobs, there is still plenty of things that you're gonna learn from this book. One of the perfect example that I can mention is actually storing the bike for the winter. You can go here and just read about how to properly prepare your bike for the winter storage, or maybe how to do basic maintenance, basic oil changes. And believe me, those things are definitely adding up as far as the cost of owning a motorcycle. So over a period of time, especially during the restoration of my Sportster, I have to say, I saved thousands and thousands of dollars on the labor cost, not to mention what I learned about the bike. I was able to disassemble this bike almost completely. I powder coat the frame. I mean, I found a place that did it for me, but I removed the engine, I removed all the components. So I have this bike completely disassembled, like 100% beside the bottom part of the engine, because that didn't really require any work. It was all in good shape. But all the upper part of the engine, the top end, I disassembled this completely. And actually the service manual was able to provide all this information that I was looking for and guide me through the process in the proper way, just to make sure that when the job is done right. And I have to say, I learned thousands of things by doing this job, and that gave me the confidence to work on my bikes later on. So I have to say, yes, it's difficult to spend $100 on the book that you might not need. But the next time when you go to your dealership for the repair, think about $100 that you can spend on this book versus hundreds or maybe even thousands of dollars that you're gonna spend on something that the dealer will do for you. And yes, I realize that servicing your bike is not something that everybody can do, but believe me, if you buy this book, if I could do it with English as my second language, I will have to say you definitely can do it. And even though if I didn't understand something at the time, I will just go and I will find the dictionary, I will translate some of the words that I didn't understand. And even with that, kind of like using common sense or kind of using basic logic will help you out, go through the process. And maybe when you are hitting this spot, when you are really stuck and you don't really know what to do next, and you read the manual and you still don't have your answer, which shouldn't really happen, but I realize that there are some situations like that when you break the bolt or did something that just happened to any mechanic that is working on any kind of machinery, then I will have to say, of course, you can go to Facebook group and ask those questions or maybe motorcycle forums. But to have the most reliable information, this book is truly priceless. I mean, actually it's $100. And this is exactly what I decided to spend my $100 on. And I have to say, I think it was really, really worth it. So if you enjoyed this quick episode, please like and subscribe to our Riders United YouTube channel. You have the icon on the right corner of your screen where you can just click and subscribe. You will also find me on the Facebook. I have the group called the Riders United Motorcycle Group, and also the Instagram account that I try to post daily pictures up there. I'm always really happy to answer any questions that you guys might have. For any other tips or maybe suggestions that you guys may provide, this is always really helpful for me. So feel free to connect with me on the different levels, and I will be really happy to answer any questions you might have. And as always, please ride safe, and I really hope to see you on the road one day. And until this time, take care, guys, and ride safe. Bye-bye.